Sherm Russo waited in his car, parked across from the house, looking in the rearview mirror every few seconds, his left hand hesitating over the door handle, trying to work up the courage to make the approach. It would take him some effort to leverage himself out of the seat. Anyone watching would have plenty of time to spot him. Jennifer called him a big man rather than fat, bless her little heart. And he did mean little, because her heart was as dried up as a prune. He and his wife co-inhabited a house, both of them too dispirited to do anything about it. Well, he was doing something now. They might come after Jennifer, he thought. Sherm had a sudden vision of his wife tied to a chair with white-hot pokers in her face, babbling about how she didn't know nothing. It gave him a moment of satisfaction, followed instantly by guilt. He wasn't a bad man, when he had time to think about it. The car door popped open, his hand making the decision for him. He sighed and heaved himself out of the seat, his belly catching on the steering wheel. He stood next to the car for a few moments, breathing hard. There was no one in sight, not a sound. It was 2 o'clock in the morning. Sherm didn't know who he should be looking for anyway. In the old days, he probably could have spotted his pursuers with a single glance. The old crew had a certain way about them, slow and languid, but predatory, each movement threatening to explode into violence. These new guys? It could be hard to pick them out. They might have been his neighbor's kids, college-educated, looking down at their cell phones, their fingers a blur as they texted or scrolled. At first, his new bosses had been a refreshing change. After all, the old-timers could turn on you for no reason. But then he realized the new guys, the little hipster shits, were just as unpredictable, their motives tangled up in behaviors that made no sense to him. When had it all changed? When had the criminal enterprise become outwardly legitimate, if no less immoral? About the time they chose that meaningless name, Airolo Corporation. About the time I started hiding my escape stashes. Somewhere along the line, there'd been a merger of the old and the new. Sherm's old acquaintances had started disappearing. Not retiring. Disappearing. At some point, he started hearing Russian accents from those who told him what to do. Something about the cold-blooded nature of the new bosses had sent him home each night with his heart quivering. He knew too much. It was as simple as that. But he was trusted, because he was loyal. I am, he thought, when you're loyal to me. But he wasn't stupid. He understood that someday the volume of illegal doings he knew about would tip the balance and his risk would outweigh his value. Or a new guy, younger, quicker, even more loyal, would take his place. Ironically, it wasn't this startling development that got Sherm into trouble, or so he thought. It was a simple mistake in his accounting calculations, the last thing he expected. He didn't make mistakes. He remembered everything. That's what made him such an asset, and a liability.